Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I have a really fun project. I will create some Christmas ornaments using wood slices. The wood slices that I will be working with are by Arteza. This is a box that contains 45 wood slices. This is real wood. They come in pretty much the same size. Of course, nothing is a perfect circle since it is real. And they also give you some twine inside the box. There are so many different ways that you can work on these wood slices. For example, you can use your acrylic paints and draw on them. You can even use your stamps, stamp and color with your pencils. However, today I'm going to show you how you can decorate them using die cutting. So I will be using these two dies by Sizzix. These are designed by Tim Holtz. So I'm starting out with the first ornament and I will be using this holly berry die as well as these leaves. All these dies come from the large Funky Festive die set. And as you can see, I did the die cutting so that I'm not going to bore you to death. I used a different colored cardstock to cut out all the different pieces. So for the base, I used chocolate brown. And now on top of it, I'm going to stick all the different pieces. For this type of paper piecing, I prefer to use my liquid glue. In this case, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. It gives me some time to slide the pieces one on top of the other until they are perfectly placed. Now, I also get a lot of questions about this little pen that I am using to pick up tiny little pieces. This is just a wax pencil that I got from Amazon. It's super cheap and it works great. I am going to make sure to link it down below for you. Now I'm going to work a little bit on the wood slices. I'm going to show this technique to you only once, but I will repeat it for all the rest of the wood slices that I'm working on. So this is a gesso and my brush is completely dry. So I'm doing a technique that is called dry brushing, where I am applying a little bit of white paint on top of my wood slice. You don't need to add too much. You can see I'm adding only a little bit at the edge. And I'm going to do the dry brushing technique on the sides as well. Notice that I'm not completely covering up the sides. I still need to see that there is wood there. The secret to dry brushing is, of course, to have your brush dry, which means that you shouldn't dip it inside water. Otherwise, it's going to completely cover up the sides and it's not going to give that nice snowy look. For sticking paper on wood, I am going to use my heat gun, and this is the one by Sizzix that I have. I am going to stick down first the two leaves, and these are cut out from a glitter cardstock. I don't know if you can tell the shine. Oh, and what I did with gesso all around the sides of the wood slice, you can easily do the same thing with white acrylic paint. But remember that the thicker the paint, the better the dry brushing. It's going to give a better look. Now these Sizzix dies are on sale at the moment. I am going to leave, just like always, links to everything I'm using down below to multiple online stores. Shop around and I'm sure you'll find great deals on everything I'm using today. So I'm going to use the string that comes in the box with the wood slices. I cut out a piece, I'm going to thread it through and just tie a knot at the top. Another fun idea to embellish those little ornaments is to tie through that thread a little bell. It's going to give a really fun and festive look on your ornaments. Now, to finish it off, I'm going to stick down a little bow that I cut out from this die set. This is a very handy tool by Sizzix, prevents my fingers from getting burned when I'm using my hot glue gun. Now, if you follow my channel, you probably know that every year I make something similar, an ornament or a decorative piece, and I make multiples of them so that I can give them to my kids' school since they have a charity bazaar. This year I absolutely love the results, so I am going to make multiples and keep some for myself as well, and I'm also going to hand out some of them on friends and family. Now, you can probably tell that I am creating the poinsettia from the set. And I absolutely love that the dies that create an element are connected, so you don't have to look through the dies in the set for which die goes with which element. I think it makes your life easier. Now, I cut out the base out of two colored cardstock, and you can see that one is darker than the other one. I'm going to stick one on top of the other, kind of offset, so that it gives a more dimensional, a fluffy look on my flower. Now, as I'm putting this flower together, I want to discuss a little bit about the back of those ornaments. I didn't do anything at the back, but you can easily stamp a sentiment there. You can emboss a sentiment. Embossing works beautifully, heat embossing on top of wood. If you love your handwriting, you can even write down anything you like at the back. And I think that these ornaments would work great as gift tags if you have to and from at the back. I used my hot glue gun to put it in place. Again, I'm going to use some string, thread it through that hole and tie a knot at the top. And to finish it off, I'm going to add some white splashes, just because they look like snow. So here is another ornament ready to go. And I think that decorating these slices is a super fun activity, Christmas activity, that you can do with your kids as well. So here I am creating another one. Again, I'm using dies from the same set. I cut out the base out of brown cardstock, and then on top I'm going to stick the green leaves. Of course, you can cut out everything using white cardstock and then color it in with your markers. I really find it very fun to use my colored cardstock. This way I can use up all those little bits and pieces that I have leftovers from previous projects. For the berries, I decided to go with these pearls, but of course you can use red if you like. I'm going for a more neutral look and feel on this ornament, so I'm sticking with earthy tones. Now, at the bottom of this ornament, I'm going to spell the word Noel. For that, I'm using letters from an older set by Tim Holtz, which is called Typography. I don't know if these are available yet. Still, but if they are, you will find them linked down below. Now, instead of those, you can always use sticker letters. You can use a sentiment and stamp it if you like, or just write down anything you like with your markers. I'm going to finish off my ornament by sticking down a little bow that I have created from satin, very thin ribbon. And here is another lovely ornament ready to go. Now I'm moving on to another ornament, and this time I'm going to create these gifts. I used the same die and cut out three gifts out of different colored cardstock. And this time I'm using dies from the Festive Things die set. If you are a card maker, I'm sure you have lots of supplies in your stash that you can use to decorate ornaments instead of just creating cards. So it's a great way to stretch your supplies and creating different projects. I inked up the edges with Distress Oxide ink and then placed everything together. I also used a chipboard sentiment at the bottom. And finally, I'm going to add some shine by using my Nouveau Shimmer pen on the ribbons. For the next one, I'm using the Christmas tree, so I'm just inking up the edges. I'm going to put it together and then stick it on top again. There is also a garland for the tree. I cut it out from gold cardstock three times and I'm going to stick it there to decorate it. But of course, instead of using this garland, you can always use little stickles or gems to add as ornaments. I find that all the dies in these two die sets that I picked up are perfectly sized for these wood slices, and they make the perfect embellishments. Now, for all the wood slices, I went with a traditional Christmas color theme, so greens and reds mainly, with a touch of gold here and there. But of course, you can use your favorite color combo and make them your own. So here I'm using again the Typography alphabet, and I'm spelling the word joy. I'm going to thread the string at the top again, tie a knot, and then again I'm going to add some splashes, just because it looks like snow and I absolutely love that look. For the next ornament, I die cut twice the ice skates, and I cut them out of white cardstock, and for all the details I used silver cardstock, so I'm putting this together. I'm also going to use one of those sentiment chipboards that says "Let it snow." I think it is really appropriate with those ice skates, and I'm going to stick those down. Now, in the beginning, I was thinking that I will go completely simple for this ornament. So I was planning to stick only the ice skates and the blades underneath and then leave it as it is. But I found that it was quite simple, so I decided to cut out some greenery and stick it there. And this comes again from the large Funky Festive die set. I cut it out from green and brown so that I can put one on top of the other. I'm also adding white splashes. This is going to look as if there is snow there. And now I'm not going to use them as they are. I'm going to use my scissors and cut them in smaller pieces so that I can create a little cluster of greenery at the bottom, just where that sentiment is. And here is the finished look with all the shine of the silver cardstock. I also added some gems that you can see in this close-up photo. From the next one, I used the bell die from the die set and I cut it out from gold cardstock twice. I also cut out some pieces from silver cardstock and I also cut out the bow from red. So I'm piecing together everything and then I'm going to stick them down on my ornament with the bow on top. That one was super simple and quick to make, but it looks really adorable. This is super simple to mass produce, and instead of the paper bow, you can add a real bow on top if you like. For the next one, I'm going to use the wreath die. I cut it out twice, once from lighter and another one from darker cardstock, and I'm going to place one on top of the other, just a little bit offset. It creates kind of a shadow and a more interesting look. I'm going to stick the bow on top, and then I'm going to embellish my wreath by adding some gems here and there. I mixed clear and red crystals here, but of course you can use any color that you like. At the bottom, I'm going to stick another chipboard sentiment that says Merry and Bright. I think it is really appropriate and it completes the look. I'm going to add the string at the top, and here is a close-up look. Now here is another completely different idea by using snowflake dies that you probably have already at home. I'm just stacking one on top of the other, and these all come from my favorite layering snowflake die set by Altenew. I am using foam squares underneath so that I make sure that it is quite fluffy. You can use glitter cardstock if you like for a beautiful and shiny snowflake. And I'm going to stick the snowflake on top. I think it's super adorable, it's super easy to recreate. If you want to mass produce such ornaments, this is a great idea. I'm going to embellish it just a little bit more by adding some gems, clear gems, on the snowflake. So here is the last ornament for today. Wood slices are so much fun to decorate and the possibilities are endless. Here is a look on all the ornaments that I made for today. And I'm sure that a Christmas tree decorated just with these handmade wood slices would look beautiful. And this was the project for today. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below and let me know if you want to see even more decorative ideas on those wood slices. As always, you will find a list of all the supplies down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.